Hello. In this video, we shall discuss the data validation feature in Oracle Fusion Data Intelligence. This functionality enables the validation of various metrics within Oracle Fusion Data Intelligence against the source Oracle Transactional Business Intelligence instance to ensure the data accuracy between the source OTBI and the target Fusion Data Intelligence. This is done in the data validation page of Oracle Fusion Data Intelligence console by scheduling data validation for a sample of data at regular frequency and using the detailed validation to investigate any discrepancies between the source and destination values in depth. Here are the prerequisites to keep in mind. Let's begin by setting up the user and custom role for validation purposes. Log in to Oracle Fusion Cloud Applications. In Navigator, Tools, click on Security Console and go to Users tab. Create a user for data validation. Ensure the password does not contain special characters or spaces. Go to the Roles tab and create a custom role. Choose BI Abstract Roles as the category and add the newly created validation user. Navigate to the Data Validation page in Oracle Fusion Data Intelligence console and go to Source Credentials to input the username and password. Go to the Schedule Validation tab. Enable the Run Automated Data Validation Reports option to set up a data validation schedule. You can choose to utilize any of the pre-existing validation sets or create a custom one. For this demo, we will create a custom validation set. Create new report. Enter a name for the custom validation set and select the source pillar. Select the metric to be validated from the listed subject areas and use the edit icon next to the measure to select the dimension values. Select the validation frequency and save. The details of the validation set can be revisited in the Show Details section. The data validation will run as per the selected schedule and the results will be stored in the data validation workbook available in the common folder in Oracle Analytics Cloud Catalog. In cases of data mismatch, go to the Detail Validation tab of the data validation page and run the validation for the concerned metric with the same column set values. The Show Summary will list the details of validation records and the Show Details will give the information on the differences in the metric values between the source and target. With this data set in hand, navigate to the Fusion OTBI instance and proceed to Administration Manage Sessions. Analyze the log of the data validation session. This analysis will help uncover the root cause of the data mismatch. The recommendation is to schedule a data validation on a monthly basis for certain data sets, if not all. There are situations where increasing the frequency of the data validation makes sense, especially when the data undergoes frequent changes such as conducting ERP data validation at the close of each quarter before finalizing the quarter's accounts. Moving forward, we shall explore some common challenges encountered during the validation process and how to address them. If insufficient permissions shows while updating the source credentials, ensure that the logged-in user is assigned the needed roles, such as BI impersonator role, within the Fusion Cloud applications. It is imperative for the logged-in user to have adequate permissions and similar data access in the Fusion OTBI instance. Failure to do so might result in validation failures, such as SOAP server error or null in source value in the data validation. If there is a null in source value or a data mismatch between warehouse and source values, review the data validation query in the Fusion OTBI session log. Check for any additional filters beyond those selected in the data validation tool. Issue the SQL with an OTBI admin user to ascertain if there are data restrictions or issues at the PVO level. In this example, when running a simple SQL on the identified PVO from the session log, it is found that the invoice ID doesn't exist in the PVO where the amount metric is calculated. In such case, collaborate with the Fusion administrator to ensure the user has adequate permissions for data access in Fusion OTBI or to determine the reason for missing data in the PVOs. To wrap up, these are some key best practices to consider when performing and exploring the data validation functionality. This concludes our discussion on the data validation feature in Oracle Fusion Data Intelligence. Thanks for watching this video.